All right, and hello everybody. I'm here with the interview today with xTcR. Just going to be talking about some general facts, just to get to know xTcR better and what they're all about. Obviously, you've got your two hosts, Leviaethin and KCIV.
Hello.
So let's get this thing started. Pretty much the first question I wanted to ask was, how did you all start to be a community in the first place? How did xTcR begin to be in existence?
xTcR was founded like around 12 years ago in Quake before moving into Counter-Strike Source. In Counter-Strike Source, we had a pretty large jailbreak and pub following, so our community really grew thanks to that. So we decided to kind of expand all Source games, and from that a few other games, and trying to offer, you know, our members a little bit more of a wider range of games to play, you know what I mean?
For sure, for sure.
So, who founded xTcR then?
That would be Kuro.
How long has he been around? Is he still around, or?
Yeah, he's still a active member and leader of the community.
Wow, nice.
Pretty much third question here. What kind of games does xTcR associate themselves with? What does the majority of the community kind of lean towards?
The ones that we have an actual active division in are Counter-Strike Source, Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Minecraft, League of Legends, Team Fortress 2, Garry's Mod, and of course Insurgency. But that doesn't mean those are the only games that we will play. You know, if a member enjoys playing a game, you know, he's more than welcome to sit and talk to people about playing a game. And we always, you know, kind of get together and play games for annual events.
Oh, for sure. I definitely respect that, because that's how FGC rolls as well. I mean, we pretty much any game anyone wants to play, and it's all good to go from there. So
exactly, you know.
So why did xTcR want to be in the competitive scene with Insurgency? I mean, obviously it's in your lineage with, you know, like you said, Quake and Counter-Strike and other Source games. So was Insurgency just like the natural next step, or?
xTcR wanted to be in the competitive scene mainly because it could be seen as a potential boost to our popularity. We seem to have been dying down a bit, and we figured it would be a great way to get a lot of new players and experience a different side, some of the older, more mature players, as well as to get some of the more popular demand from our current members in Insurgency. We had a lot of great members already in the division, and we figured it would be kind of a waste to not put them to challenge and have them face players instead of just random on the servers, have them face players who train and actually know what they're doing in the game.
Yeah. Do you ever see yourself as having your clan as having like an A and B team? Do you think you guys have enough community to hold multiple competitive teams?
Not at the moment. We probably could have enough members, but with all the current tournaments going on and being structured, we've mostly put the idea of that on hold.
Yeah.
And rather of trying to get these to run smoothly. But as soon as we start figuring out exactly what we're doing and this gets a bit more commonplace, we'll definitely put that into the works. We already have one plus reserves, so.
Nice.
Nice, yeah, that is really cool. What are your alright, let's talk about something, you know, that everyone wants to know about, everyone's been waiting for, and it kicks off November 1st. We're all excited, we're ready to go, and I'm especially so excited to cast it with KCIV, but what are your predictions for the turnout for the hosted tournament that you guys are producing for Insurgency?
Defend Alpha!
Woods?
So, my TV cut out there for a moment. Could you repeat the question?
Oh, yeah, no, that's fine. Pretty much the tournament that you guys are hosting, what were the predictions for the turnout?
So far, we are hoping for a turnout of 100 or more players, ideally. As long as signups keep the momentum we've had over the last week or so we've had it up, we should reach that goal, if not more. So, this looks to be our largest turnout so far.
Nice, nice. And it's going to be awesome because everyone that I seem to have been talking to about the tournament in general, they are all super pumped. Like I was talking with FGC Torix, and he is so excited, among a lot of other people, Link, you know, the 5K guys. So I'm just really excited for that tournament. You know, it's got me all pumped up to Shoutcast. So that's exciting news that there's going to be a lot of people attending it.
I actually have a pry behind the curtain question. How many do you have registered so far?
We have over 30 already signed up, with the forum awesome. Only going live like what, 2-3 days ago.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, that's really awesome. I'm actually really excited. I haven't filled out my form, but I've just been really busy with school and whatnot. So, how will the tournament be played, and who's running it?
Me and Woods are the main ones coordinating it. I also ran the last tournament, and Woods is kind of my secretary. the tournament will be played as our previous draft tournaments, as well as the previous ones ran by 5K and FGC and you guys. Team captains will be assigned, and each team captain will get 2 picks from the pool of players, and each pick is snaked so that it goes from first team to last, and then last team to first, simply so that picks are fair. It was a huge topic of how we could make the teams fair enough. So, like, with the amount of stuff that we're putting into this, we don't want, say, one professional team coming in and destroying everyone and yeah. driving everyone away. After each captain has picked 2 players, the remaining players will be randomized.
Nice, nice. That actually worked really well, I know, the last time you guys hosted a tournament, so I'm really excited to see this next one get played out.
That way, even if a team gets 3 competitive players, they also have the chance to get stuck with 2 randoms who've played 2 hours ever.
That is going to be exciting, though. Seems like everything's pretty balanced, pretty fair, for the most part. Now, I know of xTcR being a completely generous community. I know that, you know, you guys have a tremendous amount of servers as well for people to play on and enjoy themselves. The 30 supply servers, love them. I mean, who doesn't want to just get whatever they want and go play a game? I mean, that's the whole point of it, you know, is to have fun. So really respect that. I love how you guys just implemented different solutions into this game. But, you know, going back to the generosity of xTcR, I heard there was prizes for this tournament, and I was just wondering if we could, you know, get a sneak peek at what those might be.
Oh, of course. So far, nothing's final. So far, we have over $60 in cash and $150 retail worth of games for the winners, as well as possibly having second place prizes and other games that are going to be randomly given away during the tournament.
Wow.
However, though, the problem is there's only so many of us in xTcR, and if anyone would like to donate anything, please contact us for that.
Oh, for sure.
If you feel like you want to contribute to the future tournaments or this one, any donations would be great, because all the money that you guys put in will come right back to you.
Awesome. That's going to be really cool.
I agree.
So, I did have one question. I, as a horrible, below-average player, I want to know if there's going to be a loser bracket for me to play in.
Now, sadly, I can't say that there's going to be a loser bracket.
Oh,
but
man.
The reason for that is we want to direct as much attention to the live stream as possible. The most exciting part of this tournament really should be watching the rest of the games play out, because honestly, we're hoping to have a huge prize pool, and we're already pretty good on the way there, and I want to see the teams win. I want this to be like when you see televised the Dota 2 tournament, or when the League of Legends finals comes up. I want this to be exciting. I want people to play their games, and if they lose, sorry, you still have a chance to win prizes, but please watch the other people play on and cheer for them. We want this to be exciting.
Yeah, oh, some of the giveaways might be during the live stream, just to encourage them to actually watch it.
That's actually a really good point I didn't even think about. That's actually going to be, oh man, that's going to be exciting.
It's going to be hyped.
With a lot of people in chat specifically to watch games, it definitely builds the hype.
Ooh, I'm really excited for that too. Just having all the insurgency players, you know, watching something that, you know, I love watching a community blossom. And I like being able to play for long amounts of time and just hanging out with all the insurgency community. Which kind of brings me to my next question here. I know that the tournament is going to be a little bit longer, but I was just wondering, do you know exactly how long the tournaments usually last, or how long the last one lasted, and maybe a prediction on this one, since there's more people?
The length of the tournament will depend, of course, on the population that attends. If you guess that each round takes about anywhere from 30 minutes to 45, averagely, but it can last anywhere up to an hour. And beginning time of all the intros of 15 minutes, an average three-round tournament will last probably 2.5 hours. But with our projected member or amount of people playing, it might last anywhere from 3 to 4.
Yeah, so that makes sense to me.
Yeah, for sure.
That's gonna be a long night, but very exciting.
We will another be having breaks though.
Yes, another thing on that is we are going to be having breaks between each round so that all the games can finish and we can determine what teams are fighting who. So that way everyone can get settled, everyone can get the next game going, and the casters, you guys, can get everything ready and as perfect as possible. So our tournament will probably last a little bit longer, hence why we're starting it so early in the day. So we plan on running this one a little bit longer than most.
Yeah, wow, that's very well thought out. I'm actually really impressed at the organization that this is getting. It's something the community has definitely been needing, and I'm very glad to see people stepping up and doing that. I kind of asked this question already, but do you recall the amount of people you had in your last tournament, and do you expect that number to grow between this tournament and the previous ones?
At our last tournament, we had a slightly depressing number of only 40 people attending, at least competing. But at this tournament, we expect about double that, at least. This one is going to be much better thought out, better prizes, better people attending. It's much more in advance as well.
Yeah.
Our last one was thrown together in a week, which, considering that, did end as well as you could expect. This one, we've got weeks of preparation into it, got a lot of work going into it, a lot of hours, and it will certainly be better than the last one.
All right, well, I mean, pretty much tonight we've got a whole bunch of information from the boys here at xTcR. We're all excited for this tournament. I know KCIV and I, we cannot wait until we are able to shoutcast this and provide entertainment to all the insurgency community. I wish, you know, the best of luck to everyone who plays and participates in it. Guys, this is the hyphy tournament, alright? This is the tournament that you all want to play in and that you all need to be in. I mean, this is fun. This is classic fun. I mean, yeah, you donate a little money, you put a little, $5 in the pot, eventually that grows. I mean, you know, we could be looking at, at least a $150 prize pool if we get everyone to at least, chip in just a little bit, if that's possible. If not, it's still going to be fun. And the generosity that comes from xTcR, even enabling a prize pool in general is just... That's so wonderful that, you know, you guys would do that, and I really do appreciate that, and I really want to make that apparent, that the generosity from this clan is immense, guys. So, you've heard it first, right here, from DGL recording here. We got KCIV and myself, and we are so, again, excited for this tournament. Thank you all for listening. Hope you got chock full of information, and we'll see you next time.
Peace.